Come on, wake up, sausage.
The Vodafone voicemail service for...
Hello, it's Ben. Sorry, I...
So I'm a bit annoyed. It's early in the morning. It's not even 6 o'clock yet, and I'm so pumped for today because we've got a new toy. Well, potentially we've got a new toy. I'll see what happens. There's a lot of hype surrounding the car that I'm potentially going to look at. So my phone stays in a protective case 24/7. I just went to the loo because I took my phone with me and I took it out of the charger. It's the only reason it's out of a case.
That looks good though.
Yeah, brilliant. 5 seconds is out of case. It's been in there probably a year. Let's go. You got the keys.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, he's a big Beyonce fan.
Massive Beyonce fan. I love it. You want to see me properly dance? You don't want to see me properly dance, actually. It's too sexy. Too sexy for the camera. That's it. I've got to have a bit.
I can smell that from here. What was it? Monster?
Going.
They're getting old, mate. That's what happens.
So where is this car that we're going to go and look at anyway? What part of London?
Oh, I had to feel like a new man. Where is this car? Harrow. Is it Harrow?
Hello.
You know, the problem is you were desperate for...
Oh, mate.
...for the toilet, but I am desperate for...
Where did it go while we were there?
And number two, I ain't using dock leaves and leaves, mate. Not being funny, if I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it on a throne.
Oh, mate.
With my phone like a newspaper.
Do you know when you need the loo so much that it aches and you're like, ah, I just can't. Yeah, anyway, enough about that, enough toilet talk.
Oh, get me out of here. For this now.
What?
What in the fuck? What is this?
It's Beyonce. Oh, yeah,
yeah. What happens when I get a choice?
I'm gonna lie, but I've never seen this much green in London.
You ain't been to London enough.
I've been to London enough.
Full of greenery it is. Full of greenery.
Is it?
Yeah.
Well, wherever we're going, it looks quite posh.
It does look nice, doesn't it?
This is nice.
Isn't it? It's always reassuring when you go and look at a car, look at the house and look at the driveway it's parked on. Tip for anyone buying a car.
Look at it.
Look at the surroundings. Whoa. The
place is mental.
I'm sorry. I didn't get the invite from Scarface on the way up here.
Jesus. Oh, look.
Yeah, mate, it is here.
That is nice. There you go, that's got to be a mil and a half, isn't it?
Jeez. Quick, act natural. All right, well, here we are, in a nice posh part of London, isn't it?
It is posh.
Well, nice.
Got really posh.
The guy's young, so he's probably not going to be awake yet. I've sent him a live location, and I've sent him a text saying we're in the vicinity, and he hasn't responded yet, although the message has delivered. So. I'm going to give him a call in a moment. Maybe we'll film that, maybe we won't, I don't know. I'll give him a call, see where he's at. We're in the right place, because the pictures he showed me,
yeah. This
looks like the right area.
Yeah.
Might give the game away, if you're filming the screen. Come on, wake up, sausage.
The Vodafone voicemail service for...
Hello, it's Ben. Sorry I can't take this call, I'll call you as soon as possible.
Oh, Ben.
Yesterday would be good.
Oh, Ben.
That's never a good start, is it?
No.
We were up at 5:20 to find out the guy's still asleep. Potentially. He might be having a nice breakfast somewhere.
Yeah, nice posh. Well, it is posh place.
Yeah,
I didn't
see
a cafe, though.
He's probably having nice
salmon. I could do with a coffee.
Bagels with salmon and scrambled egg with a little bit of pepper on the top.
Here in the undergrowth, we have a Stuart Hoy in his natural environment. You've seen the footage with Bigfoot. Well, yes, he has some rather big feet.
Look at
it's not a safe toilet tree.
Yeah, but when you got to go, you got to go, innit?
No, I'm getting to that point, but I need you to keep an eye out.
All right, I'll be your wingman. Look, look, there's no one up there. Nothing's happening there. I can see at the back, I've got tinted windows. You'll be all right.
Oh, don't film it.
Go on. All right, so I've turned the camera off. There's a car coming. Can I ring him again? Can I ring him again? You were like, don't ring him, don't pester
him. Ring him then.
Wake up. A bit dodgy, sat in a van on a fucking posh estate.
Hope you got your tax for that NPR camera. Is it taxed?
I don't know. Medical inquiry service, that's it, isn't it? It's a bit worrying that I didn't know if it was taxed or MOT'd. It's MOT'd until October. That's good, isn't it?
Well done.
Bit of luck when you own an MOT station.
There is news. Yes, we've been here, what's time now, 11 o'clock? So we've been here 3.5 hours so far. I told the gentleman that I was going to be here at 8:30. We were up at 5 o'clock this morning, we left. Got here real pronto. Found the place where the car is, the car's on the drive. Knocked on the door, no answer. Rang him, no answer. Dropped messages, all that sort of stuff. Went to the next door neighbours, the next door neighbour said, yeah, they're around, they're really cool. But if no one's there, I can't help you sort of thing. So I left a phone number with the next door neighbour. And went for a coffee, didn't we, Stu?
Yeah, we did. Mackie D breakfast.
Got a McDonald's coffee, got breakfast. And I've just turned up and it looks to be his brother has just gone out for a driving lesson. I said, is he? And he said, oh, you must be Owen. I think he's probably, he owes you a conversation or something. So the poor kid's, I think he's still in bed. He just rung me and he said, I'm so sorry, I overslept. I'm so sorry. So in a minute, the first thing I'm going to do is knock on his door and I'm going to barge my way through and go to the toilet because I'm breaking my neck for a wee again.
All we've been doing is going to the toilet this morning.
No. Anyway, so it looks like it's going to go ahead. We were a bit despondent, weren't we?
Yeah.
We were thinking, you know, what's
it was all too legit it was, for it not to be. But anyway, so, we're not going to show him around the car at the minute.
No.
But we'll have a look at it and then maybe reveal if you decide to buy it.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Sweet. Right, let's go and have a look.
It's so unpredictable at the moment.
It's windy as hell.
First it's t-shirts, then it's sun cream, and then it's a scarf. And I think I just felt rain. Well, not a happy
make,
shirt.
Let's make this quick then.
Do you want to know what I got?
I think they know because they've just seen the clips.
Well, if you've seen it, then you'll know I got the Volkswagen Golf Pirate Edition. Oh. The Golf. Arr!
It is rain as well, though.
Yeah, I told you. I knew. Oh, it actually is rain. Oh, we better wrap this up quick. Anyway, so I picked up a Golf R. Well, I wanted something that I could use more daily, something that wasn't a muscle car, something that didn't have a jerky clutch, something that I could use and have fun with, but I could also use it on track that wasn't as expensive to repair as the Porsche. So that's the plan for the meantime. It's an APR, it's got an APR intake, it's a Stage 2, APR Stage 2 with a DSG tune as well. It's fairly stock, the suspension's stock, the brakes are stock, but it's a good all-rounder. It's about 400 horse, something like that, but it's going to be a good daily all-rounder, and it's the newest car I've got. So actually, I'm impressed it's got parking sensors and heated seats and all that sort of stuff. We're going to nail it there, and we'll give you some more footage when we get back to the shop. Right? So you probably saw, hang on, yeah, we were in Reculver earlier, me and Stuart. We're in Reculver. We decided, yeah, we're going to do some shots here, and we're going to talk about it here, and it lashed it down. We were there, what, 3 minutes? 5 minutes, and the heavens opened. So we've shot back to the shop to give you a quick talk through of, again, just reiterating why I've bought the car. So I took the Porsche around Brands, had a wicked time with it. So, so much fun. I spun it. Did a little dinghy on the oil pickup pipe, which comes out the bottom of the turbo, and I've had to buy a replacement for it. But it then sort of brought in the mindset and my thinking process of, actually, what if something else happens next time? What if it gets shunted into? What if the engine goes bang properly and the cost involved in that? So then I was kind of thinking, actually, going forward, do I buy something that's a designated track car? Well, the Porsche is a designated track car, so is there anything that fills the gap in between? So it's a road car that can perform, do all the stuff that I can on the road, but then use it for a track as well. What's behind me is what I picked. There was a few things in there like Audi S3 and Megane. I think, Stu, you mentioned Megane. What's the mark, the late one? RS250, quite a nice car. But came back to this. So I wanted something that ticked as many boxes as I could get, but still be fun at the same time. And we picked this up this afternoon after a little bit of waiting around. But
you broke it already, haven't you?
Yeah, a little bit. I managed to drive it over 100 miles back from Harrow. Yeah. And at the speed bumps in St. Peter's, I managed to just clip the front of it, and I've taken an edge off the spoiler on the front, which is brilliant. Always manage to break something, don't I? Well, so I'm a bit peeved about that, but you know, it is what it is. It's not lowered, it's stock suspension. Quick rundown on what's on it and what's been done to it. Have I already done that?
Yeah.
Did I say it had a stock suspension?
Yeah.
Okay. It's got front spoilers, rear spoilers, bunch of other stuff, and apparently it's about 400 horse. So yeah. We're going to take it for a drive. We're going to stick the draggy in it and see how it performs. And
we're going to be doing the draggy in a different video against all three cars.
Oh yeah, fancy that a bit. Okay. Join us for a drive. We're going to go. It does everything so well. As you've seen before, with a lot of my cars, I tend to go quite extreme. So I want stuff that's like fast, noise, powerful, and the rest of it. Not to say that this isn't powerful, this Golf R, but actually it ticks a lot of boxes. And the fact that it ticks a lot of boxes means this, it makes it a great daily car. I looked at Audi S3s. To me, I thought that Audi S3s were, the cars of the same age as this looked older. And the Mark 7 Golf R was really like a nice sharp looking car. I really wanted a Tornado red one. I really wanted a two-door, and I wanted DSG because I wanted it to be able to be a street car, like a regular daily sort of car, but also have some performance behind it and be able to do a track day. So I haven't pushed it that hard, but I just like the way it just does everything. And I got into it and it's automatically connected. My Bluetooth is connected to my phone, the heated seat's on. The seats are nice and comfy. It's got Alcantara interior. I don't know if you can get that in the passenger seat there. Auto lights, all stuff that really, if you've got a car that's reasonably new, you're going to be saying, well, actually, you know, that's not, what's the big deal with that? But for me, I've never had a car new enough to have experienced that. I suppose the most deceiving thing about this is that it is really fast, but it doesn't feel it. It feels, everything else I've got or have driven feels fast, even if it's got less power than this. Like on the motorway, you look at the speedo and you're doing 100 miles an hour and you don't even know it. Whereas everything else I've got or have driven, you definitely know it. It's just good at everything. In typical German fashion, it's brilliant at everything. And a few aesthetic changes that it's done, that the guy's done. A few little tweaks, and it looks kind of aggressive as well. I really prefer the Mark 7 over the Mark 6 and a lot of the Golfs after the Mark 2. Even the Mark 2 to some extent, they don't look very aggressive. Yes! There's a few flat notes in it, to be fair. There's quite some orchestra coming out of the tailpipe, but sometimes it's a bit of a B flat. So anyway, contrary to what I've been driving up until now, this is the complete opposite, and it's absolutely awesome. Effortless, it's so effortless, that is the trick to it. Absolutely effortless to drive, which actually I really appreciate now. Having a few cars that are a bit like, hold on tight, it performs really well, but doesn't require like massive wrists and forearms to shift gear, and it's just very light to drive. I don't know how I can get angry driving this, unless I'm racing someone else, of course.
That's so good.
You've had it an hour and you're already being the standard dog.
I'm such a dick. It makes you want to drive like that though. It really does.
Fits.
Oh yeah. I'll take it. Look how shiny that is now. Stu's done a fantastic job on that. I still love the Celica, even though they're an old car. So, if you want to see what we're going to do with the car, or what we're going to use the car for, like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell, follow us on social media as well, because we've got tons more fun stuff coming up with this. Track days, mainly. Ta-da.